Well, if we look at the VIX index or just statistical measures of volatility, it's not even wobbling. And wobbling, that would be a usual thing for equities. So the global economic backdrop is very resilient. And therefore, corporate earnings and growth and all these key parameters are all in place to support further positive development on equity markets.
The interesting thing is the VIX isn't really capturing where the buckets of volatility are, though, is it? We're talking this morning about a big move in the ruble around American reaction to the Novichok poisoning. We're also talking a bit about how the Asian markets are moving here because we've seen this terrific sell-off in Chinese equities. How do you weigh your more positive view on broader equity markets with some of these specific problem areas?
Well, of course, there's volatility at the fringes of the global system. That's clear, speaking of Turkey, of Russia, of whatever, Venezuela, Argentina. But that's not terribly relevant if you just look at the size comparison within the global economy, unless you have a kind of critical factor like oil prices. But even that is still in bearable territory for the time being. So, I mean, there's lots of noise, and then there's summertime, of course, so the noise is amplified, tit for tat in trade and all that stuff. But in the overall context, compared to size, it's not relevant.
Do you think the trade concerns are fully baked in? Because to me, there seems to be a lot of optimism in the market. I reference even Brexit, despite the fact there's always a possibility of a no deal. The market has not moved aggressively till now, obviously we get much, much closer to the deadline timeframe. When it comes to trade tariffs, it feels like it's the same thing. The market is open to the possibility that there may not be some form of a resolution, that we see an escalation, but they're not willing to fully price it into the markets unless things really turn bad last minute. But if you look at the language from the Chinese, they are ratcheting up tensions as well, and they're not backing down. I mean, the comments overnight suggesting a mobster mentality from the US, effectively demanding protection money, doesn't sound like this is a fight that is going away anytime soon. So is there a risk that the market loses that optimism because we get to some sort of position where effectively it's large numbers lobbed from both sides, and then the market sells off? Could that be a potential risk?
Well, there are two factors to that. One is size. Even the tit-for-tat volume affected in trade is irrelevant to the overall trade volume. That's a fact so far. Of course, that can escalate, but not to a level where it's relevant for the market right now. Second point that's more important, financial markets are pretty bad at adjusting to structural shifts. Yeah. And not even structural shifts. I mean, we can remember the last 20, 30 years when there was then the final rate hike in the cycle of a central bank, the Fed to speak, the straw on the camel, we had a bond market shock. Yeah? So even a normal economic parameter adjustment can be painful. So things happen when they happen and not before. So the adjustment is not smooth. And that means we are in a late stage environment. I think we have a slow motion credit crunch going on, but we are still quite a bit away, I think 6-12 months from real pain. And you know, the Chinese of course don't back down on trade. The Europeans will not back down on trade. And it's the only way to treat with this US administration anyway. So there will be escalation, and we'll see who will blink. I think nobody will blink.
And then, Beat, that raises the question of those economies that could get caught in the middle. I think of Japan, given the data we had that Karen talked about in the machinery orders today. The interesting line here to me is the overseas machinery orders fell 12%, mm-hmm. and that was the biggest decline in more than 2 years. Do you think we're already seeing signs of the noise on trade denting CapEx, denting sentiment for orders here?
Absolutely. In terms of consumer sentiment, perhaps a bit less, but investment sentiment, business confidence, you know, you can take the Japanese situation, you can take Brexit, you can even look at the recent figures in Germany. It has an impact, and it has started to have an impact. And I think also there will be a rethinking of global multinationals about managing their value chains and to go more regional in order to take care of these concerns.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.